Hi YouTube, I just thought I'd tell you about how I do the raspberry stitch. A lot of people have been doing the raspberry stitch. I'm only going to show you the part where I'm using Norwegian Pearl because I don't need to reinvent the mousetrap. I'm using blue, so you get blue raspberries. The raspberry stitch is four rows. Row 1 and row 3 are purl. Row 2 and row 4 are your pattern stitches, and it's worked on a multiple of 4 stitches, so what you have when you want to set this up, say you wanted to have 5 raspberries across your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 times 4 is 20 stitches plus 2 slip stitches. That way you have your selvage. Okay, so let's get going here. Now I tend to get all over the place when I'm Norwegian purling, and I apologize for that. So I'm going to try and behave myself here. It's not that easy with a camera between me and my knitting. So slip the first stitch as if to purl. Now here you can see I have 3 stitches. I'm going to get a little closer there. Hopefully my camera focuses. You can see there was an increase. So where you were increasing before, you want to decrease. So we want to purl these 3 stitches together. Okay. And I use my modified purl for doing that. It's a modified German purl. I'm just not using my index finger in the wrap. Put the yarn to the back. Then you knit, pull up a loop, but leave the yarn on the left needle. Then come in from the back, go to the back of the work, pick up a loop, come back through the loop that you're knitting into, and then go back in, pick up another loop as a knit stitch. So you've got knit one, purl one, knit one. Yarn forward. You want to go ahead and purl here. Now, if you did this as a German purl, you just put your finger on there and purl through. But I find that my thumb is already there, and it's easier for me to do it that way. So here we have our increase, knit one, come in from the back, go to the back, pick up the yarn, come back through the hole, and go back and pick up a knit stitch. Now we purl these 3 together. And I find by putting my finger here across the top, it makes going through there easier. So there's my purl 3 together. Now you can, there's your knit stitch, come back in and do your Norwegian purl, and one more knit stitch. There's your 3-in-1 increase. Come back to doing your purl. You can do whatever purl you want to in here, but I like this one because it doesn't hurt my arthritis. Now while you're knitting, if you want to do the German purl or my modified purl, you can just bring the yarn in front, then you pull it to the back and do one more knit stitch if you prefer. That's also possible. I'm sorry, I bumped the camera. So we have another purl 3 together. That's what I'm saying, you really have to purl loosely on your rows 1 and 3, or it really makes it tough to get through there. We have an increase. Now you can increase. I'm going to show you what it's like to bring that through as a purl. Well, I got to tighten this up to be able to do my purl. Then you bring it through. I just think it takes a lot longer. Bring the yarn to the back. And then use your modified purl or your regular purl to purl those 3 together, and you knit the last stitch. Turn the work, you will purl across. Now I don't need to show you that. I would just use my modified purl to go across. Maybe I'll show you that, because you can actually build up a bit of speed with that, and it is more comfortable. For me, it is more comfortable. So this is what the modified purl looks like. I'm going to do it slowly so you can see what I'm doing. And you still want to use a loose tension to do this, because you got to remember those purl three togethers. And really what you're doing is the tension is holding, it's on there. If you want to pull that through without putting your thumb there, it's just what's comfortable to you. But when I purl for a long time and I'm bringing my finger, you know, way down, I feel it in parts of my hand where my arthritis hurts, whereas when I'm doing this, it doesn't bother me. And I really wanted to learn continental, because I do have arthritis, and sometimes when I'm knitting English style, which I know how to do too, my hands get tired. And I've knit enough and practiced enough with continental that I can knit English style or continental all in one piece. And I do like the modified purl, because the tension for the purls and the knits are the same, and my stockinette comes out the same whether I'm knitting English or continental. And there is my demonstration of raspberry stitch using the Norwegian purl and the modified purl. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching. See you next time.